Jay. Just come to catch up with James here at Megan Turbo, and
there he is. How you going, man?
Yeah, good.
So, what have you got today going on?
Ponsonby's a little bit different from the most. Yeah. We have everything from your Toyota Corolla to, Ford Territory, maybe even a Tommy Mackinnon.
You have one here?
We have one here. Well, actually, on top of that, we have two.
They have two. Is it both of them?
Yeah, so we've got one out here, and we'll show you another one outside in a second.
Oh, wow.
So just doing brakes on this Mackinnon. Tyres going on Ford Territory, alignment on the SLK 200 Mercedes. And another Mackinnon.
Two in one space. It's, you see them, you hear about them, you think, okay, how rare are they? And they are.
Well, obviously. Two in one building.
Yeah, but we're in New Zealand. People in America are surprised we have as many Skylines as we do.
Yeah, that's true.
Let's get back out of the wind, shall we?
Yeah, sure.
Well, back in the shop, we're having a quick chat about wheels, how big they are. Now, you've got 22s.
We've got 20s, 22s. This is probably, in New Zealand, this is probably the most common delivery is 20 to 22.
What does that go on?
That's mostly SUV market.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, whereas for your cars, we're doing anything from 18 through to 20.
And
occasionally
that's
21. Norm is 18 to 20. 21 it seems to be more of the bigger Euros. So
yeah.
Audi RS6, S4s, that sort of thing, where people like to just push the envelope, have something that fills the guards.
Yeah.
Most of your Japanese vehicles is that 18 to 20 delivery.
Right.
So you'll get, you know, your Toyota Chasers, Aristos, that sort of thing. They'll run a 20 if they want to, but 18s, there's more tyre choice and availability. So that's where we run them those.
I remember when 17s were a big deal.
First set of wheels I ever fitted, which was 26 years ago,
were
17s on a Mazda Doc Turbo Familiar.
Yeah.
Yeah. Very, very different today.
And when I got 17s on my car, I thought I was awesome, but now I get wheel envy.
Yeah, yeah.
What's the most interesting set of wheels that you've gotten here at the moment?
At the moment?
Something that
I'd probably say the Ferratas are going to be more on the lines of something that's a little bit different. So Ferrata is a wheel brand that's exclusive to us as Mag and Turbo for New Zealand.
Yeah.
They've got dish in the sense of depth and also concavity, so we've got a bit of angle going on, and that's what most people are after, is that concavity. Here's another Ferrata that's a 20x9, not as much concavity but bigger brake clearance, so the spoke itself gives us that ability to actually clear the brakes,
and it's actually got a nice machine look to it as well. It's actually done really, really well. So these are a one piece,
they're a single cast wheel with a clip and ring, you can also buy three-piece wheels, or, you know, you can buy two-piece wheels.
Yeah.
It just comes down to what you're after at the time, and then obviously price.
What kind of cars do you see these ones mostly on? A variety, obviously.
So we've done these on everything from a GDR R35 through to a Ford Mustang.
Yeah.
Probably most common in New Zealand for Mustangs. The guys really don't like the factory black wheels that they come out on. Audis. We're not seeing so many Commodores anymore, so that whole delivery of 5120, which is their PCD, has really changed.
I've got a Commodore, don't I?
That's where it
fits. Wow, yeah, I've got an adventure.
Yeah. And even BMW now has changed their PCD from 5120 to 5112 for all the new vehicles.
5112?
Yeah, so 112mm
for
their bolt central position, or PCD, and that lends itself to the European delivery of vehicles. So 19s seem to be the European choice, so all these are 5112, you know? 5112, 5112, 5112. So
that's the thing, that's what everyone, well, that's what you've got to run now if you've got one of those vehicles. Yeah.
That's it.
Oz Racing, haven't seen that in a while.
Oz Racing, yeah, so these are a set of 17s even. Look at that, 17x9.
Oh, they're four lug. They won't fit my Lorel.
No, they won't fit your Lorel.
Okay, now, you know my car as well. What do you reckon would be a good wheel on there? We've talked about this every now and then.
As I said last time, I think the big thing is for you to come probably up to an 18, mainly for tyre choice, because there's a lot of 18s around.
17s are dying off?
Not as much tyre development in a 17-inch, because everything goes to a bigger brake as you're getting into that motor racing sort of thing. So 18s tends to be where it is.
That's interesting to know. 18s is sort of...
18s up. Like, don't get me wrong, you run on 19s, you run on 20s, but 18s, you're going to have the best grip and tire delivery available to you.
And then last following up is 4x4 stuff, really, isn't it?
Yeah, so four-wheel drive, six-star is the predominant, but in...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
But the one above is a 22, and that there might go on the new Land Rover Defender. So the new 110 or 190 series Defender.
Yeah, Land Rovers are 5-lug, aren't they?
They are 5-lug. So, you know,
in which is quite surprising. You would think if it's 4-wheel drive, it'd be a 6-lug, but.
Yeah. It's, well, Volkswagen Amarok 5120.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
So Amarok being the SUV or dual cab pickup ute.
Yep.
And 5120 as well, so that's definitely the next sort of step.
Yep.
In the bigger American stuff, we deal with 8-lug. So
right, so that'll be your big Chevy.
Yep.
F350s.
Yeah, so
as
we
well.
Did Dodge Ram.
Oh yeah.
8165. All this PCD is dependent on when the vehicle is made, because some manufacturers will run one hub for 3 years, and then the next 3 years they'll run a different hub.
Yeah.
So you don't actually know until you get the vehicle that's manufactured, and then you've got the same deal with like Dodge and Ram.
Yeah.
And now Ram only, like separate manufacturers, and they are produced in different factories to where they were originally.
One's in Canada, one's in Mexico.
That's right.
So are these heavy as well, or they're relative for what they are?
For the load rating, you do get a lot of weight in them, so yeah, they're strong. That's the whole idea.
Yeah. Because like, if you look at a steel wheel,
steel wheel's heavy, like very heavy.
For me it would be a two-arm.
it's a two-arm lift. But, you know, like...
Popular because they're simple.
And you can hit them with a hammer if you need to.
Yeah.
Not something you want to do with an aluminium
wheel. Nah, not at all.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go, six as well.
The set of 13s beside you there is actually for a Mini.
I have tried to fit 13s on a Mini before, and tell you what, it takes a lot of work.
Yeah, you need fiberglass flares for that.
Yeah.
So these here have a AR1, which is a Nanking semi-slick, I suppose, dot-approved race tire.
But it'd be really, that's super sticky, isn't it?
Super sticky, yeah.
Yeah. On a Mini, that would be like driving on rails.
Well, that's the idea.
Yeah.
If you're gonna have tyres, you might as well have something that sticks.
Especially on a Mini. Hey man, thank you very much. It's been
no problem.
Good quick tour. We'll catch up with you again soon.
Thanks, mate.
We're going to talk more about specific details of things. And
we'll get into suspension next time. That'll probably be the next step.
Yeah.
And lowering or lifting.
Yeah.
Or even just stabilising.
Certainly I've got to lower my car at some point as well. But
yeah. No.
Thank you.
No
bye.
Problem. Cheers.